Hello again, this is your cultural Catholic Joshua Zeller, and today is Domestic Friday. And so the two biggest stories of the week have to do with Donald Trump. And you'll notice below, hashtag Donald Trump. I do not own that. That was started by Cenk Uygur at the Young Turks, and I have to say it's a brilliant idea. So if you got, I'll have some of their videos in the link in the descriptions below, links to their stuff. You guys should check them out, as well as the other two creators and commentators that I have down there, Secular Talk and The Majority Report. All three of them had very good commentary on what was said here, as did Trevor Noah at The Daily Show. And so the first one, obviously, was the Second Amendment people comment. Donald Trump was saying that Hillary Clinton, if she's elected, she would appoint justices who would essentially abolish the Second Amendment, which any Democrat would say is insane because most Democrats, most liberals don't want to take away all guns. They just want to have sane reforms, such as getting rid of military-style weapons, high-capacity magazines, armor-piercing bullets, you know, things that civilians definitely don't need. And so Donald Trump was saying that if Hillary Clinton gets elected, she'll appoint liberal justices, and then they will rule, and that'll be bad for the Second Amendment, for the Second Amendment, as he said. And he said that the Second Amendment people could do something. Of course, he does say at the end that that would be a very bad day, giving him. I'm not taking the entire thing and ending it right at the Second Amendment people. It's the entire statement in its entirety. Donald Trump's supporters are not always the most in tune with reality. 40% of Donald Trump supporters say that if he loses, it's because Acorn, which hasn't existed since I think the 2008 election, would have stolen it from him, which makes a whole lot of sense, as well as a good number of them thinking that Hillary Clinton is literally Lucifer. We can thank Ben Carson for that, but still, there could be some people in Donald Trump's support camp that could do something really stupid. Either they try to assassinate her now, or if she's president, or try to assassinate nominees to the Supreme Court. Now, of course, he has backtracked. He has tried to walk it back slightly, like saying that he means that they'll go out and vote, or they should go out and vote. And a lot of his surrogates have tried to walk it back the same way. One of them was kind of crazy is how she tried to walk it back for him. I would probably give him the benefit of the doubt and say he's trying to inspire his supporters who like the Second Amendment to go out and vote. But it's still not something that he should say, and of course, the Secret Service either has or will be talking to Donald Trump. Hopefully, something of this. Hopefully, what he meant was that he hoped his supporters who like the Second Amendment would go out and vote. But again, it's not a very good precedent for Donald Trump to say something like that, especially with what we know about his supporters. And of course, the most recent thing that he said was how ISIS is honoring President Obama. And how he and Hillary Clinton would get MVP, and how he and Hillary Clinton basically co-founded ISIS. Which makes no sense. Since, even though he called ISIS or ISIL or Daesh, which from now on I'll be calling it that because they don't really like being called Daesh, it's a derogatory word. That is made up of an acronym of their name in Arabic, hashtag Daesh. And so he's conducting military operations against this organization. Now, it is factual to say that Hillary Clinton, with her voting for the Iraq War, initiated the process for ISIS to exist, because without voting for the Iraq War, without the Iraq War ever happening, the region isn't destabilized, creating a vacuum for powerful organizations to form, like Daesh, and for it wouldn't have the same opportunity to, do what it's doing right now. But to call them the founders of ISIS, especially since Barack Obama wasn't even in the Senate at the time, is completely irrational. And of course, Donald Trump likes to say, "I was against the Iraq War," even though there's clear audio from before the Iraq War where he supports going into Iraq and he supported pulling out of Iraq, saying that they're in a civil war. And what are you going to do with a country that's in a civil war? So it's kind of hard to get behind this candidate. Not that I was behind him ever. I personally supported Bernie Sanders. But what kind of person is going to believe a guy who makes up crap on the spot? Jimmy Dore on the Young Turks pointed out that it appeared that he came up with that idea on the spot and just kept on going at it. You could see it in his eyes, and when I watched the video, it was like, yeah, he literally just came up with that on the spot and is now just going with it. Whenever he's asked about it, he doesn't back down. He doubles down and keeps on going at it and going at it and going at it. If this man wins, I don't know what went wrong. Granted, the polling right now shows that he might not win. But if he does, something would have seriously gone wrong. And so, what this man says is insane, and we should not let this man anywhere near the White House simply because he's coming up with crap that isn't real and is acting like he lives in a completely different universe. So, again, hashtag loser Donald Trump. This is Joshua Zeller from Culture.